There must be some way out of here, said the Joker to the thief. There's too much confusion, I can't get no relief. Businessmen, they drink my wine.
So to start off with the story behind Heaven's Door, we have Ryan Perry. I've been with Diageo for numerous years, and a guy by the name of Mark Buscella that partnered up, and they formed a whiskey company. Now, Mark Buscella's name to fame is that he was the creator of Angel's Envy. Angel's Envy, a well-known whiskey, and of course, he was the CEO of the Angel's Share brand. I think it was eventually sold out to Bacardi. I think it was in 2015. But the two of them teamed up, and they were going to do some, they wanted to get into doing some whiskeys, which their background is, in a partnership. And the interesting thing is Ryan Perry read that Bob Dylan had actually, he had put together or had registered the bootleg whiskey as it was a registered name that they took kind of an interest in, because they felt that this could be a good relationship, the partnering up with him, and maybe working out some kind of an arrangement with his interest in whiskey, and that possibly putting something together in a partnership, probably similar to what Matthew McConaughey did with his Long Branch, by the way, which is going to be ending this year, his relationship on that partnership. But anyways, it took a while, and they decided not to go with the bootleg whiskey name, and of course that was really nothing to do with whiskey. That had a lot to do with his unreleased albums. And so, but eventually they did get a chance to use it with the whiskeys and that. What's interesting is that they all kind of looked at what his, one of his biggest hits ever, Heaven's Door, Knocking on Heaven's Door, and kind of for some reason felt, geez, we could go that direction, which kind of created a bit of a lawsuit with Heaven Hill. And that's another story, but we'll talk about that one later. But eventually they worked their way through it. And they even eventually, because they were sourcing this whiskey out in the beginning, when they actually launched it, they were sourcing it out. But in the end, they've actually found an old church, 160-year-old church in Nashville, that they've turned back into a small distillery for doing some more craft distilling. And this would be more finishing barrels and that kind of stuff. So that's probably enough said right now. Bob Dylan, he's, of course, not just a musician, but he's also an artist. He also does, he builds these extravagant gates. They're worth a lot of money through his business in Los Angeles, Buffalo Iron Works. And, of course, on this bottle, you see one of his gates, his iron gates. And he does a little presentation, and you get this little... you open it up here and you get a little bit of a read and a picture of Bob Dylan. And of course, me being a Bob Dylan fan when I was a kid, I mean, I'm going way back to Highway 61. That was my interest in grabbing this bottle. So we're going to do a quick review on a new player in the block, Heaven's Door. And a lot like Matthew McConaughey, we have another celebrity here. I think Matthew McConaughey was Long Branch, which I hear is going to end this year, their partnership. This one is with Bob Dylan, of course. And we're going to give this a review. Let's start with the nose here. And interesting little picture on the label here. This is Buffalo Iron Works. That is Bob Dylan's gate design. There he has he builds gates and he sells them for a pretty good price. some of his artwork. He is an artist as well. Of course, we know he's an incredible musician. And he shows a little picture of one of his gates on the bottle there. So, the nose. Caramel, vanilla, honey, a little bit of maybe some cooked pears, apricots, a little bit of cornbread maybe, just coming out of the oven, getting the strawberry notes. Here comes the grain. Yeah, the oak, the grain and the oak. More vanilla. And of course the spices. A little tobacco on the tail end here. A little bit of tobacco, maybe a little bit of cocoa. And some peanut funk, like that's a Jim Beam thing. Okay, let's try the palate. Cheers. Sweet. Spices. A blend of, I'm going to say vanilla fudge. And boy, some hot cinnamon. We'll get a little bit of pepper coming in now. Oh, I got some fruit. Back to the old berries, blackberries, strawberries. Buttered cornbread. And there's always a little bit of vanilla when you get that wood. My understanding is this is 6 to 8 years. Minimum of 6 years, but some of the sources say 8 years. So, oak barrels, so a little bit of the oak. And again, you know, I'm going to say maybe some white pepper. And peanut butter. Mixed with cocoa, and there she goes. Not a super long finish, but it's not dry. Let's try the finish. Well, back to the cornbread. Vanilla and lots of tobacco. Spices. Yeah. And a little bit of the cocoa still. But it's the finish is a short medium, I'm going to say. I'm going to put a little bit of water in it. We're going to see what water does to it. The water always opens up and sweetens it up, but in this case here, this is a spicy drink because I'm still getting a lot of spice. Still getting the tobacco on the tail end there. Still got some, I'm going to say honey on cornbread here. And this cinnamon's turned to almost like a ginger. Maybe even oregano. Anyways, let's try the palate. Well, vanilla fudge mixed with pepper. Pepper and vanilla fudge. Black pepper. I'm going to say it. This is going to be like a medium finish, eh? Definitely is going to be a medium finish. Short, medium finish. But it does. It doesn't dry the mouth out. It's got a good mouthfeel. Spicy still. Spicy right to the end. Now, I am kind of rushing these because I'm going to go through a Blanton's too, and then I'm going to kind of run the two together. So, we'll sort of give each one a kind of a score after. Actually, I'm going to give it a score right now. I'm going to say that this is in the 70s. So, Heaven's Door, I'd probably give it a 77, somewhere in that range there. Good whiskey. It's one of those whiskeys that it's a little on the different side in that it is a spicier straight bourbon. I believe that the whiskeys are sourced out. They do have a new distillery now. It's in Nashville. It's an old church, 160-year-old church, that they're doing a lot of their barrel finishing. It's a smaller distillery, so they'll still probably source out and do some of their barrel finishing at this new distillery that they've got in Nashville. So, but overall, just a little bit of a spicier. They do have three of their presentations. I think there's the rye and there's the double barrel that are part of their brand presentations and that. And then they are doing a bootleg series. And these, I think, are aged. They're going to be age statements. I ask you to drink wisely, drink intelligently, do not drink and drive. And until the next time, cheers.